Praxis Prepper.
Hey everybody, this is Praxis, and in this video we're talking about the Day 17 episode of Praxis Prepper Alien Invasion. We'll talk about some of the discussion points and topics brought up in the episode, and at the very end I'm going to share with you a sneak peek of what's happening on the Day 18 episode of the series. But first, if you haven't seen the Day 17 episode, here's a link somewhere. I know that YouTube lately maybe has not been sending out notifications about everything, so if you happen to miss that, here's a link so you can watch before we talk about it. YouTube's not a big fan of my channel anymore, I don't think. The algorithm, anyway. I don't know. I'm getting buried for some reason. Okay, anyway. Click on that if you need to. Anyway, let's jump right in. But first, I want to thank all the people that have, jumped in to make, all this possible. If you're not familiar, the only reason I'm able to do these, big, complicated episodes is from the generous support of people just like yourself who've gone to patreon.com and for as little as a dollar a month are keeping this whole thing going. And the people that jumped on just during the past week or so to help out are no one, actually. We had a huge jump when the Day 16 and a half episode went out, because that was the first one where it's like maybe it wouldn't go out if we weren't at full funding. So a lot of people jumped on board, and the reason that they did that is because if you jump on board and you become a Patreon supporter of this channel, again, it's just like as little as a dollar per month, you get guaranteed locked-in access for all the episodes. Even if the funding goes below full funding, the way I kind of figure it is about $400 per month is enough that, give me the time to put in it's like 40 hours or so to make these for the month. So even if we go below that funding threshold, I'll keep making them, but they may only go out to Patreon people. But as long as we stay above that $400 threshold, they'll keep going out to everyone. Right now at the moment, we're just a little bit above it. It fluctuates. So, if you want to lock in your access to this stuff and never miss an episode, link down below, patreon.com/PraxisPrepper, and you can get all that access. Plus, you also get behind-the-scenes stuff and, ways of interacting with the story, helping to steer the plot, and, other promotions and cool things that I do on just the Patreon side as well. So, anyway, if you want to jump on there, patreon.com/PraxisPrepper, join those people, and you'll never miss an episode of Alien Invasion. So let's talk about this one. This is a big game changer on the 16 and a half episode, and this is the first one where Monica and my character are out starting from scratch, square one, and we're using a lot of kind of like Boy Scout skills, really. Well, it's not called Boy Scouts anymore, it's Scouts. So Scout skills, Girl Scout, Scout. Yeah, it's supposed to be a huge controversy, but honestly, whatever way you're getting kids out into the woods, that's a good thing. I mean, there's an argument to be made that, there's a benefit of having, just girls together when they're doing that and just boys together, so they're not trying to impress each other and all that kind of, dynamic. I get that, but I think that's a lot less important than just getting kids out there. So whatever way you're getting kids out there, Scouts of America, that's cool. As long as you're getting kids out and learning these skills, because they're important. And in this episode, there's an illustration of why it's important, is because if you lose everything, the ability to kind of make for yourself just out in the world, in wilderness, it's a great skill to have, to be able to start a fire, to be able to kind of set up some kind of a rudimentary shelter. Obviously, in this, we're using a tarp. Maybe later in the series, there's going to be some other skills. maybe that tarp gets lost, Who knows what's going to happen? But you guys do. I just told you pretty much. I think these are really important skills, and one of the things that's really important about them is to practice them. Now, I was just out at the new place that we're building. We moved to this new home here, a temporary home, and the purpose is that we're near a place where we're going to be building our homestead version 2.0. And I was just out there the other day with my boy. There's some streams that go through there, really beautiful. I'm really excited to get out there. And he's playing in the water, and there's some mosquitoes, so I start a little fire. Now, just the day before, it had just dumped rain on us. I usually, when people say it's like pouring, I'll be like, yeah, it's kind of like a heavy drizzle right now. But it was really pouring. I mean, just buckets coming out of the sky. Everything was really soaked. But the very next day, because I have experience, because it's something that I do frequently, I was able to pretty reasonably quickly start a fire. And the only thing that I brought in with me was just a lighter. All the materials were there. We found some hemlock, dried hemlock sticks, and those dry out really quickly in the sun, so those were doing pretty good. And we found just the the top coating of leaves on the ground, you know, that had been in the sun for the morning, those had dried out enough, and we found a few little fluff pieces of some white birch bark. And if you're familiar with white birch bark, you know that stuff goes up like, you know, napalm. It just really, really burns well. So between all these things, we're able to start a fire with completely all wet materials. And that kind of thing doesn't happen on its own. That happens from practice and experience, learning what works, learning what doesn't work. And I think it's really important to practice all these kind of skills so in a crisis you're not going through all of those kind of, you know, trial and error learning things, because you're going to have bigger things to worry about if you ever, you know, get booted out of your house and you need to be living in the woods. You know, you don't want to be having to worry about, can I start a fire? You want to be learning, figuring out, like, oh, you know, is there that mob of crazy people that's going to attack us, or, you know, all these other things that might be, you know, going on in a, like, SHTF emergency. You want to be thinking about those things, not about, like, how to start a fire or how to throw a campsite together. So it's good to practice those things. What are some other skills that you think, you know, in terms of bushcraft, getting out into nature, that you think maybe people don't give credit for how much trial and error work it takes to really get good at those kind of skills? Do you find that you have ever gone out into the wilderness and you wanted to try like a bushcraft skill or something like that? Maybe you had a book, because books are great, but until you actually, you know, get your hands dirty and really try these things, you don't know, like, what are the hard things to do? What are the easier things to do? Have you ever gone out and you had something, you had a really good idea of how to do it, you've seen maybe videos on YouTube, you've, you know, read from the books how to do it, and then you actually put your hands into it and you're like, man, this is more difficult than I thought. There's a video that I did a while ago, here's a link to it if you wanted to check it out. It's called, like, you know, Why You Can't Pick Locks in, you know, Post-SHTF. And, you know, I talk about how lock picking is kind of difficult. You know, it's not as easy as you see in the movie. Someone just goes, I'm in, done. You know, maybe someone's good like that and can do it that fast, but I certainly can't. That was an example of a skill that, you know, takes some practice to do. You know, you can't just, like, kind of get book smart about it and then think that you're going to be good at it. Most people in that video seem to think that the video is specifically about lockpicking and lockpicking only, and it is about that, but the video was intended to be a broader video about the idea of just skills in general, things that are more difficult than people give them credit for. And practicing is a really important thing. So I'd love to hear your thoughts about things that are really important for people to actually practice, things that are important for people to get their hands dirty, really get that sense of what works, what doesn't work, so you can get your trial and error out of the way before a crisis. All right, enough about that. The next video, the Day 18 video, is coming up. Again, this is, you know, wilderness survival stuff out in the woods. Big game change for the series. I don't know if you guys realize it, but the reason that I had to have my character get booted out of the house was because I was moving. And, you know, while I'm still back and forth between the two places, I'm mostly at this new place getting ready to build the new place. So, you know, it just wasn't going to logistically work out for my characters to stay in that old house. But beyond that, I think it's just fun and interesting to kind of, like, shake things up, try some new things, because that's kind of what, like, SHTF and collapse and preparedness is all about, is, like, getting curveballs thrown at you and then, you know, making the best you can with them. So that's it. Here's a clip from the Day 18 episode, and thanks for watching. And that works in this way. Got a little notch on here so it can balance or rotate over the fulcrum. And you can see I'm just going to hold it just like that, so it's staked into the ground, and up here can take quite a bit of weight pushing down, and it holds the whole thing together. And I'm using my knee is going to be the squirrel, so something comes around here and it's kind of messing with the bait here, it pulls it out and the rock falls down and crushes it. So that's the way that thing works. So I'm going to make a few more of these. Please subscribe and tune in every Friday at 4:30 New York time for a new video. And if you'd like to support this channel, you can do so both through Patreon or PayPal.